Well, we're from the police 911. We have an immigration protest happening right here. Who's that kid? So we got Coin 6 and Channel 12 here. They will too. All right, how's it going?
There's a spare body.
Sometimes we have to be sharing faith, especially if you have my son. My son.
Okay. She's in
that court. Yeah, girl. All right. McAdam. You know that Highway 43 that goes all the way to... Okay. All right. I will. All right. Bye.
How's it going, my friend?
All right, how's it going?
Pretty good. Just wanted, are you taking pictures or a video just for yourself?
Video.
Video, okay. Are you just taking it just for yourself or for any group or anything like that?
I do it for From the Police 911.
For what?
From the Police 911.
Okay.
I'm an activist that films the police, make sure they don't violate people's rights.
Awesome.
And I also cover protests.
Well, then I'm glad you're here. Yeah, totally. I'm just checking in just because I just want to check in with everyone who's taking film. Thank you. Appreciate it.
You're welcome.
Six two two one five one zero. again refer back to your Know Your Rights cards. You have the right to remain silent the whole time. You have right to an attorney. And we're just here to like share our stories. Do you want to get started with a chant?
Yes.
Woo! Cool. Woo! When it goes really good with a chant, I'm going to pass it on to him.
Well, thank you.
Who's got a friend?
All right, how you doing?
I'm going to ask you to stop recording.
When
we
I
have
say people
for
you
this
say
event that are designated people to our media, and there's going to be plenty of pictures.
So. Okay, people, but I'll still do it anyway.
Okay, well, if you're going to be
recording,
then
you can do it. We're documented!
Well, you can ask all you want. This is public
floor. We're documented! We're documented!
Okay, well, what are you doing here? What are you doing here?
Awesome.
That's what
so
I thought.
I'm trying to change the place. Who are not afraid of coming on the
okay
show today.
I'm going to
have
Private
start it off.
You were trying to dox people. I know your channel.
Hey, what up, everyone?
If you know my channel, then you know that I go. I film the police. I film protests, and I don't like the police.
Okay.
Well, I got more to lose than you do. Okay, so F you.
We have vulnerable people.
I got vulnerable people too.
But okay.
Yeah. Where are their police?
Huh?
Where are their police right here?
For so many years.
I also cover all the protests too.
Right. Well, the people at this protest, they were asking that people don't film, except for people that they specifically asked to film. And so if you're here with the protest, then I guess the
question
is,
I'm here with the press.
What? Are you here with to support the people that are here?
Yes. Here's the deal. I will support the people that are here as long as they support my rights.
Right.
Okay. My ex-wife is an illegal alien from Mexico. My son is from Portland. My ex-wife faced deportation. If they deport my ex-wife, my son goes too.
And I'm also a documented.
And so what we're asking is that because like these people are vulnerable, right? They're saying that we don't want their faces everywhere and stuff like that.
Okay.
And so we're just asking. They're asking, right? Not even me. They're asking not to be recorded, except by specific people. So I guess like since you are in support of them, and I know you are, like you just said.
Yeah.
And so since you are in support of them, I guess it's like how can we just like how can we like know that you have your rights and also hold to their request and asking not to record.
Okay, here's what I'll do. I will not record the speaker or the people that are speaking. I'll aim my camera this way. That way I don't get all the people there, but I still get the protest. Is that fair?
We can check with the organizers and let you know, but thank you for being flexible.
Yeah, I appreciate that.
All right.
For real. Thank you. When people start coming out, you can catch them doing that and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And you'll be able to catch the stories there. And just not getting faces and stuff on the camera.
Right.
Not facing towards the actual people. That would really work.
Okay.
Thank you, brother. What was your name?
I'm Bob.
Bob Isaiah.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right.
Mi nombre es soy un hermano, soy un hijo, soy un estudiante, un trabajador, y alguien que está peleando por sus derechos y por su comunidad de esa calle.
Because I'm being real. So, already
to the States as a minority. I knew I was different. The difference settled in when my brother and I would sit down and try to speak English. Not knowing the language was the first struggle. We knew we one had to learn the language to vocalize once a week. Language gave us more opportunity. But I knew I had to do more than speak English. I had to assimilate into the country in order to survive. I knew that we were living in a secret. We were living in fear. I was oblivious to the fact that I was a Muslim and that at any time I could be detained and taken back to a country that gave me life, but a country that I did not call home. Years ago, my father woke up, went to work, without knowing that he would never see us again. He was approached by ICE at work and taken away. His only crime was wanting to provide for his family. I remember the thoughts of my mother, my brother, and I. The room had a sensation of darkness, gloom, and sadness. As she tried to nurture us back to life with her touch, none of that worked because we all knew a big piece of our hearts had ripped from us. Fast forward to the year I graduated from high school. History would repeat itself. My older brother was detained because he was without a license. My brother was unable to see his family, even though he had a child who wondered where daddy was. But now I carry pain and frustration in my heart. I visited my brother while he was detained, and I walked through the halls. I remember the feelings of being in a museum where one cannot touch or walk without permission. The only noise I could hear was echoes of our steps. The rest of the scene was a blur. When I saw my brother, I immediately teared up. I cried tears of frustration and uncertainty. I didn't know if I would see him again. Soon after, graduation day came, and he was still detained. My mother wanted me to be happy, but triggers fired in every direction. My brother at that moment was taken to Tacoma, Washington. This was about 3 hours away from home. The morning of my graduation, I received a phone call from my brother. In a subtle voice, he congratulated me and indicated how proud he was. I cried hearing those words. He stated how he wished he could see me walk, receive my diploma, and hear my graduation speech. I didn't know it yet, but at that moment, I had decided to stop letting fear control me. I decided to take action and fight for me and my community. We don't get to choose where we're from, but we deserve to have the opportunity to access a better life.
So this is the ICE building right here, which I'm going to have fun after the protest.
Undocumented and unafraid. I am a mother, a daughter, a grandmother, a micro-enterprise owner, and a radio host. I too am a community member and a volunteer. As I said, I have lived in this area for 13 years, and I am a grandmother of two American children, a boy who's 6 and another one who's on the way. Like many others, I left behind a place that offered no promises or work, which only offered an employment project.
There's an ICE agent looking out the window.
I'm seeking the safety and the future of my daughter. I came here.
What?
I wanted to give my child.
I was videotaping that ICE agent over there. And I was told I can videotape the building, just not the speakers.
I too am a daughter.
And soon as the protest is done, then I'm gonna go have my fun over there. And you know how I feel about law enforcement. I feel about ICE a lot worse. Okay.
Little did we know of the many dangers that people encounter when living in these lands. Estoy aquí hoy para pedir un cambio. Como miembro de la comunidad, he visto miedo en nuestras comunidades, en nuestras comunidades, a pesar de que vivimos en un estado santuario. I'm here today to ask for change. As a community member, I'm seeing the fear that our communities have, despite the fact that we live in Central State.
If you know me, then you know how my First Amendments are. Then you know how I do my First Amendments.
Despite the news that nothing is happening, the denial of the local transportation campaign, I hear of more and more people being detained and disappearing, especially in the last few years. I am seeing the disintegration of our communities. These are people who only want to work and live in peace. I see that these rays are destroying our communities. I am talking not only about the parents, but it is the fear in the eyes of the children. Not only my grandson, but many other children who are born here to immigrants like me. This is what worries me, among other things. It is those families that are being separated as we speak. As a mother, it feels like a trap, and you must choose whether to stay home or to risk being detained and taking your children to school. It is inhumane that you must think of where to find refuge. These children are Americans who are witnessing their families being torn apart.
Stepdaughter that was deported to Mexico.
I understand how you feel about ICE, but again, it's just for this event to provoke in that way, just to keep other folks safe.
Mm-hmm.
I'm here to ask to let us continue to doing the jobs that most Americans don't want to do.
So I'm being asked to respect the people that tear apart families and deport loved ones to other countries, including people that fought for this country that came over from the Middle East and are facing deportation and beheadment. Women and children that have deported would be killed, and ICE has been given orders to deport as many as they can do. So, and I'm being asked to respect such a group. You know, I can't believe the protesters are asking me to respect ICE. Mm-hmm. Who's the No, what I'm doing is they said I could film the building. Otherwise, I'd be out here. I don't even want to film someone that might risk deportation. That's not my thing. Okay? I have a stepdaughter that was deported. I have a stepson that's risking deportation. I got an ex-wife that's looking at deportation. And if my ex-wife goes to Mexico, so does my son.
Yes!
And I'm being asked to respect that.
I cannot hear you. Do you have our back?
Yes!
Okay. Okay. None of the leadership has approached me. Well, security team doesn't mean it. They're not leadership. Okay?
We are approaching you on behalf of leadership. We are following the instructions that we've been given.
Mm-hmm. Okay, then let me talk to someone with leadership. Did leadership tell him to respect? Did leadership tell him to?
Turn your device off and wait until it's done and you can talk to anybody you want. They're busy right now.
Well. My device. Yeah. Unfortunately, I didn't know ICE was here.
No shit.
No shit. I thought they were in Tacoma.
Weird.
Huh? Because I thought the ICE was in Tacoma, where their detention facility is. Yeah. I figured they had one or two officers in the FBI building. And I went over there and did First Amendment audits over there, too. In fact, I was one of the ones that flew a drone over the FBI building on 9/11. Me, Mike Blue Hair, and Demi.
That's pretty badass. I worked. I paid the bill.
One of the reasons I asked you not to provoke is not to respect ICE by any means, but like respecting the organizers, because they're taking great risk being out here in the first place. And so what they don't want to do is to provoke in an extra way, like anybody else provoking in a way that they haven't decided to do themselves.
Here in Portland, so I transformed my life. By taking great risk and so keeping them a safe as possible, at the Cable Community Radio, in the church, and as a health promoter.
Senior footage. I hear the shit that you say about people.
In this city, I met love. My daughter was born, and I have many friends.
Yeah, don't.
My brothers and sisters. In my life,
I hear the mock people. I've heard the racist and transphobic shit you've said.
You don't know me from a hole in the ground.
Yes, I do.
Unfortunately, the government has come to transform to upset the Oregonians from sensitivity and to see us immigrants in a different way. Where before they did not see us, now they point at us. And it's very sad that the small percentage of Oregonians are bringing to the light their hidden racist feelings.
As many other immigrants, including millennial Trump, I came to this country with a visa. Like President Trump's wife visa, mine expired too. And we both continue to work here. I do with the sweat of my forehead, and she does with the sweat of her influences. I have never been a criminal. I have never raped anyone. I have never sold drugs, neither here or in Mexico. I do not deserve to be deported because of my situation, the color of my skin, or my accent. In my country, where everything happens because of political influences and corruption, I wouldn't be able to find work because of my age. And I would be a perfect target for violence and discrimination because I'm a single woman and a lesbian. Today, what brings us here today, in front of the immigration office, is not just our story, it is the story of thousands of families being separated.